My name is Jelle, and welcome to the fourth episode of Sustainable Packaging in a Circular Economy. This week is all about reuse. What do we mean when we talk about reuse, and how does it fit within a circular economy for packaging? In this episode, we will visit Repack, a reusable packaging service for online retailers, to investigate the environmental and economic benefits of their service. Senior lecturer Bas Flipse explains how performing a life cycle analysis can help you to make informed design choices about your packaging system. We will also discuss how circular business model archetypes can be applied to fast-moving consumer goods such as packaging. But before we continue, let's take another look at episode 3. We were very happy with the lively discussion in the forum. So, should we replace our current packaging with bioplastics? It is safe to say that most of you disagreed. According to Nina Altenberger, we should be focusing on changing lifestyles instead of substituting one material with another. Malcolm 2001 argues that using bioplastics just to create more single-use packaging would actually be a step back, and that by designing for multiple uses, we could use our resources more effectively. In the assignment, we asked you to look for bio-based alternatives. Jolijn Schoofs found this deodorant stick made of paper to replace an aerosol spray. She does note, however, that some users may not like it when the stick touches their skin. C. Villarneau found this biodegradable container for pre-cut fruits, which is made of sugarcane fibers. Yet, the real question, she suggests, is whether people need pre-packaged fruits at all. These are just some of the great examples we have seen on SketchDrive. Keep up the good work. Now, let's continue with episode 4.